remember the fight.
Okay.
All it's right. very important to remember this. Don't give up the fight, because in Ghana, if you give up...
Who are we fighting? That's a problem.
We're fighting the harnesses. I mean, the bad attitudes in Ghana, the road carnages, the bad roads, the light issues, the water issues. We're fighting all of those. Because what's a better Ghana?
Hey, good morning. It's Tuesday. Welcome. Today is what? Day 14.
Yep.
Yeah, of the month
of May. It's 14th.
Yes, 14th May.
Flying.
Yeah, tomorrow will mark how many years since Ex-President Rawlings and the junior officers decided that they were going to do something.
Oh, okay. Yeah. May 15.
Yeah.
May 15. 79.
Before he was freed by Major Mbwachi Jan, and then June 4th also happened. Yeah. Okay.
Exactly.
Oh, okay.
That's what's happening. But yesterday, speaking of standing up for your right and the bad attitude that we have, yesterday I took time to go to 4 male washrooms in Ghana. I went to the AMA's new complex. I went to Aliza Hotel. I went to the Accra City Hotel. And then I went to Movenpick Ambassador Hotel. Male washrooms, because I couldn't go into the female washrooms for security reasons. And I realized, sadly, that even though all the hotels were neat, the washrooms were clean, they had a lot of running water, they had soap and sanitizers, many people walked in there, did their business and walked out without washing their hands. The number of people who looked really, really responsible, you know, wearing suit and tie, some, you know, they looked decently dressed, they looked
so
responsible. And they walked in there and walked out without doing anything. So after they finished sprinkling, they just walk out with it. And I was just imagining how we are sharing gems and
the sharing is real, Johnny, because that person is going to touch the door and you are also going to have to, you know, handle that door. And then you get to the place, probably the plates are stacked on each other. He's going to pick his plate. Remember, his fingers are going to touch the next plate and you're going to pick it. And so these things are real, and I think it's right that you're talking about it now. These petty things that we fail to, you know, recognize as something that contributes to the burden of disease in the country is real, and we have to talk about it. And I'm happy that you're saying the people you saw were people you thought would be, you know, responsible because they look well dressed. But unfortunately, it's the other way. You'd be surprised that the woman who will look down upon in the market is actually the person doing the right thing. She would wash her hand after using the washing
yesterday,
even though it's public.
I was so scared, you know? Because for me, as a social enthusiast, I like shaking hands with people. And so people don't have a certain perception of, we are channel, you know. I'm naturally like that. I like to shake hands and familiarize and socialize with people. And I was just thinking how many the quantum of gems I take along from people every time.
That's why you should have the sanitizer at least.
Well, I mean, at the AMA's new complex, for example, they have the two washrooms on the side and they have the sanitizer dispenser outside the door.
So when you're leaving.
So that even if the assumption is that somebody has come there, contaminated the thing, and then you can just sanitize quickly outside. Maybe that's a concept we need to start using. But I was so disappointed that our hand washing culture, in spite of everything that
people
the Ghana Health Service has been talking about, nobody is taking a look at this. So, Dr. Antonio Insiasare, good morning to you. You are doing a fantastic job, and with your team out there, Jacob and the rest, but the people are not listening, trust me.
Maybe they're starting from the schools. I mean, most of these public schools around, you find them sometimes even improvise with plastic.
The Veronica buckets.
Yeah. Yes. So maybe I have always said that, look, for our generation, we cannot deal with sanitation. We'll pass through the system and go. But I strongly believe that our kids will come and deal with it. All that the politicians say, they are just talk. To deceive people for vote. But the real people I see are young ones who are growing up, because now you work with a young person, primary school people, and you drop litter and he quickly or she quickly
tell him to pick it up.
Right. And I get excited about it.
Yeah.
You go to the public schools, these bucket is there, and you find them break when they are returning to your classrooms, they are washing. So let's hope that they have picked it, and so when we have faded off and gone,
It's a lost battle for the elders.
It certainly isn't. But my worry when we come to this, you know, coexistence, because until you fade away, you're still here with us. And the unfortunate thing is where, you know, they fail to recognize what the younger generation is doing and applaud them for it. Because you've got other older ones who corrupt you by saying, oh, this is Ghana. You're allowed to drop it anywhere. Because I had an instance when I used to use a public transport. I sat in a public transport and someone dropped the sachet outside. And I said, oh, you could at least even leave it in the car, because from what I understand, they'll clean it up and that will be neater. And he says, oh, Nasa had the AS lorry pack, it will be out to form, you know. And I thought, okay, so if you're teaching me this and you're making me look as if this is the right thing, it's okay to do it, I will probably start thinking it's okay to do that.
Let me tell
and
you.
So please, as you live, for now that you have your few years left, don't corrupt us. That's all the younger generation is asking of the older generation.
Let me tell you.
Don't corrupt us, please.
I think that as a people, we have not punished persons who actually, you know, flout these regulations. We have not punished them enough.
Yeah.
And you find the district assembly is always talking about education.
Mm.
We have educated people enough.
Right.
The laws are there.
Mm.
Punish people. People deliberately litter.
Do it.
Yeah.
Mm. People deliberately litter. Right. Look at this, what you were being told, I had the SLB to Tunyama. Who instituted that?
Mm.
We have become so comfortable with filth.
The wrong.
And we keep finding an excuse as to why we can't be a clean society. That's wrong. So deal, punish people. Stop education.
For years, we have.
I was happy. Sorry about that. I was happy when the AMA started jailing people for open defecation and for littering, and they couldn't pay. I was very happy. Then you had people coming in to beg for them.
The human rights.
But if we don't do that, How do people change?
How does it become deterrent?
Let me tell you a story. When I was a teacher, I used to teach at a senior high school. I won't mention the name of the senior high school. So we took a trip all the way down to Accra.
Mm.
And because we wanted the kids to feel what they see on TV, what they see in their books.
Right.
So we came to Accra, Parliament, at that time the castle, and other exciting places. And then the kids there, they had not seen, you know, it's difficult to find, how do they call it, coconut around there.
Mm.
So they got to Accra, bought coconut and were excited. Mm. We're sitting in the car and we're eating them. So you know how heavy the husk is.
Right.
So this young boy finished eating and just flew it through the window.
Wow.
We had to spend one day in Accra because the car that the husk cracked the windscreen.
Wow.
Was I think belonged to one of the ministries, and so we had, I mean, the driver,
to go through the processes.
So a whole day we had to stay back in Accra at an extra cost, and so that's how bad the situation is.
Wow.
And so, like I said, if the kids of today do not start, pick the habit, imbibe it, keep it in them, we might end up not achieving anything.
Mm.
As for me, I'm saying that our generation has failed.
Mm.
We can never correct it. If any politician comes and tell you that I'll make Accra clean in the next 10 years, look at that person and tell the person that he or she is not telling the truth, because the others will tell you, if it will rain, you look at the clouds.
Mm.
So if you look at the clouds and the sun is there and you think it will rain, you are mistaken.
Mm.
We are not doing anything to ensure that we're cleaning our places up.
Mm.
And so how do we say that in the next 10, 5, 6, 12, 20 years, Accra will be clean?
Unless they start punishing. So unless they're doing something different from what they've been doing all these years. Until then, we certainly won't get results.
You have people who go into washrooms and they take bottled water into the washrooms. I don't know what it is that they go and use it for. And then they leave it there.
Yeah.
So you find that all of a sudden, even though there's a rubbish bin there where they can actually drop the empty
bottles of water sitting there.
Yes, they are sitting on the sink.
Well, maybe in our situation, case the taps.
If it's the taps may not flow and you use the water, drop the.
Yeah,
drop
I'm
the
just
thing
making
then,
a very know, silly excuse for people. And, I mean, why would
then,
you do that?
And then you find others. They go into the washroom. They take the paper towel. Mm. They wipe their hands. Mm. In trying to drop it into
it
the bin, it falls and they leave it.
There's a bin.
It's a
big
situation.
I mean, if there's no bin, that's different. But this thing, if we say we're talking about it, we'll spend the whole day.
Just this morning, BBC, there was a story on BBC about some people who had gone down the belly of the ocean, very, very deep, very, very deep, I mean deep. And they were talking about plastics there.
Oh,
wow. And that is not the beaches we're seeing. No.
Yeah.
Deep into the ocean.
Right.
And I mean, they spent days and days to get there. Mm. They stayed there for 4 hours.
And they found plastic.
Right. And talking about that, plastic. I think I've seen a similar documentary. I can't remember if it's Wildlife, Nat Geo or something, but animals, even birds, who have had plastics attached to their wings and so they can't fly. Yeah. Others, you know, in the sea, they've got the plastic on their face and so they're, you know, dying. And if we don't talk about these things, extinction is real. And very soon we wouldn't even have the fish to eat. And so these things, when we do them, we have to think about the long-term effects. Everyone is thinking about me, myself, and I, and how it impacts my life. And so far as it's not affecting me, it's okay. Mm. But it goes to affect the other person who's related to you in some way, somehow. Either the economic benefits you lose. I mean, it's a ripple effect. We have to stop it.
Yesterday when the rain started, we were told that the NADMO had been put on high alert. Yeah. And they were waiting. I started laughing. I said, NADMO, your first job is to prevent the disaster from happening, not to be on high alert for when the disaster happens and then you move in there. So the president said earlier this year, the president said that bring me a national disaster plan. You remember the president said that?
Yeah.
Where is the plan? We are in May, the rains have started. We know that we'll have double portion of rain.
And that's Kaswa for you.
That's Kaswa.
Yesterday when it rained, some portions of the area.
So if you live in this kind of place.
This is away from Kaswa, the same Kaswa.
I think it's a stretch, yes. Right. If you live here and you're at work and you just see the showers start, what would be going on in your mind? Can you work?
I'm hoping you leave home before the rain starts.
But if it does, how would you concentrate?
I used to have a lecturer at Legon who said that if he has a lecture and you see clouds, don't come because I won't come. When we asked him, he said, Accra is not a safe place to drive when it rains.
Right.
And so he won't step out.
He wouldn't want to lose his life.
So, and that's productivity.
Yeah, productivity is affected. And I'm saying that NADMO's main job is to prevent the disaster from happening. The president has asked for a disaster plan. We don't have it.
These flooding, most of which is as a result of the fact that drains are choked.
Yeah.
People are built on waterways.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And so for the greater part of the year when these plastic, the sachet bags, the black ones, they get into the drains, they choke the drains.
Exactly.
So the very first heavy rain comes and the rain will have to find its way onto the road.
Look, Engineer Ben Atta spoke with me on Community Connect about 2 weeks ago. He said, we can desilt all the gutters in this country, keep our environment spotlessly clean, but if we don't take certain measures, we'll be in trouble.
We'll still be in trouble.
He said our gutters need to be re-engineered so that we can have all the smaller ones flowing into a bigger drain.
Yeah.
What we have now, we don't have a lot of that.
We don't.
And you remember that the president, and I'll say this again, the MPP prior to the 2016 election called for the fact that promised that they were going to have a hydrology authority to deal with issues of flood and the rest. It's 3 years already, and we don't have any sign
of the authority. But you see, it's
a manifesto promise. We're not told how many ministers we're going to get.
Oh, but you said we don't want, some of the promises are probably not meant to be fulfilled.
It's important.
They are documented for
documentation. Then engineer talks about the fact that make the regulation such that everybody's land space will leave at 15 or 20% of that land space where water can run off and seep into. This culture of everybody doing pavement blocks and tiles in their homes to show that you are rich or what, it's not helping us.
If we're even doing it and doing it the right way, it probably wouldn't be a problem. Because outside, you've got most people having pavement. Exactly. But whether the engineering mechanisms that go into it is the problem.
But outside, those who have those things pay certain taxes on it because your water will run off into somebody's earth.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you will have to pay a certain amount of it. And plant trees.
Okay.
Plant grasses.
The morning is expected to be exciting.
So Nadmo, don't be on high alert. Look sharp.
Oh, but they are.
And of course, the newspapers are ready. Wow. We'll take a look at them. Daily Rand is also on. Sports, we'll keep talking about what's happening across the country, I'm sure. Today's Tuesday.
Yeah. In Chamber.
People
are burning, I mean, in their homes because they can't. Some can't get people to come and take the rubbish, and others are just flouting the laws and others just doing what they want.
In this instance, somebody's burning refuse behind somebody's window, and they can't sleep. Mm-hmm. The children get asthmatic attacks.
I'll get up and go and put water on it.
If this is at midnight, you're going to spoil your sleep and go and, you know, quench that fire.
Already, I can't sleep, so I'll get up and jam the wall and go and put water on it.
That's all. No conversation.
That is so mischievous. The things he didn't do when he was a child, he's now learning.
I'll do it. I'll just get up, jam the wall, come and with a bucket of water and put it on.
Okay, so that probably is a solution to
if you're stronger than me, then you can fight. If you're not, you dare not fight. We'll talk about that later on the chamber. And also, man term in Punto, district development, if I do a literal translation. We'll be coming to you from
more like a clone of community connect. Yeah, that's so.